he wants so badly to live in the Ready Player One universe because he'll finally be cool and he won't have to wear sunscreen. And it's just like,
Layla!
No, you are not making your child get this. Is dad went out for cigarettes and never came home. This is so bad, Chris.
Dude. Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
Dude.
Absolutely.
Dude,
absolutely. Damn, you are having a great run. I don't want to be that guy right now, but
never, ever, ever gonna let you go. Once I get my hands on you.
So, I talked to my dad on the phone for like an hour and a half last week on Thursday. No, on Friday.
Has your mom called you yet about today's episode?
No. Did she call you?
No.
She texted you?
She hasn't said anything yet,
oh,
which is weird.
Might
normally,
well, she's leaving for Arizona for a month on Saturday. So,
whoa.
Yeah. She's like staying with my grandparents and stuff out there. And
are
then,
they dying?
No.
Oh, okay. She's just going for a month?
Yeah, so like because she's not subbing right now, she doesn't have work, so she's going to just stay out with my grandparents, my dad's parents, and then her aunt also stays out there, so then she's going to end up staying with her for a while.
So since she's not subbing in Minnesota, does that mean she's going to be doming out
nice.
In Arizona?
Nice. She's always a dom. You know better than that. But she also has Cookie Con in a few weeks. So,
what?
Yeah, dude.
What is Cookie Con?
So it's like Comic Con, but for cookies.
Edibles?
No, I wish.
That's what I was going to say. Like, is it?
You know what? I wouldn't be shocked if there were a couple of booths at Cookie Con that were edible based. But
so wait, is Cookie Con in Arizona?
No, it's in Reno.
Oh.
Yeah, so she's going to Nevada. She's staying in like northern Arizona for a part of it. And then she'll just drive up and go to Cookie Con. And then when she gets my dad's flying into Reno, and then they'll spend
some
time together.
Dude, that drive from Arizona to Reno, so beautiful.
Yeah, because you get to go through Sedona and Flagstaff, and like, it's just all the best parts of.
And you get to see the Metabolic Mountains, and.
And you get to see Jeff Dangle's package.
Yeah.
Jeff Dangle? That's not even his name.
I knew what you meant.
Idiot. Jim Dangle.
Is it Jim?
It is. It's Lieutenant Jim
That's
Dangle.
That's close enough.
Mara, how the fuck are you?
Yeah, how art thou?
Are we playing podcasting?
Yes, now we're
yeah, I mean, we could be. I mean, you're playing multiple nice. Things right now. Who gives a rip?
Well, I wasn't sure if it was recording.
Oh, yeah. But also, keep doing as you're doing. This is fun for all of us.
That's what I've been doing. I've been playing video games on the internet.
Nice. How's, so what, okay... Both for myself and for our audience, what is your actual stream schedule?
I've been streaming around 7 or 8 until midnight.
Okay. So between 7 and 8 to midnight, and that is daily?
Most days, and then Wednesdays I usually take off.
Ah, okay. Take off, eh?
Eh.
And then Thursday I take off too.
Okay, so Wednesdays and Thursdays are off, and then you stream Friday.
So far, that's what it's okay. kind of been.
All right. Well, then,
which
so...
been working out, I think.
Yeah, because I'm trying to figure out, like, when I can watch, because typically in the evenings, Caitlin and I hang out, and then when she goes to bed, I also, like, go lay in bed, and then I don't really do it. I just watch random shit, so I could probably just watch your streams.
Oh, well, okay. The last 3 nights, I believe... I think I got it started on Sunday. Yeah, so the last 3 nights I've been jumping in too. And so yeah, I try to get Mara on Discord, and then so you can at least hear us both talking.
Yeah.
Even though we're doing different things.
Yep.
Well, actually we're doing the same thing.
We tried to play Phasmophobia, but like my computer didn't like it.
Yeah.
That's annoying.
Can I tell you what happened yesterday?
Did you get your first win in Super Auto Pets?
No.
Oh, I was really hoping that's what it was. Go ahead.
He's the losing the whole time.
Round 10.
Dude, it's so weird, the learning curve in that game. Like, you play like 2 hours and you're like, I fucking suck at this game.
But I thought I did.
By the time you reach 3-4 hours, you're like, I'm great.
Is victory not the same as win?
Well, you got to get 10 wins.
Yeah, 10 oh, that's how you win?
Yeah, that's yeah. a that's a,
mm,
that's
a then no, not even close.
That's winning in a run.
Okay. Now, yesterday I was planning on super auto petting my balls off because I had started to loop music that I had made.
Yeah.
To use for the background, yeah. And I even like got on earlier and was like, I'm going to make a beat specifically for tonight.
Oh,
so
hell
I
yeah.
started doing that.
Yeah.
And then literally right as I was about to start, Kim comes in. I'm saying like I opened Super Auto Pets. Kim comes in and goes, our bathroom ceiling is leaking. And I'm like, oh, I didn't even explain anything. I just got up my chair and I went to Landon and Layla were freaking out. They don't know what anything means.
Yeah.
So I go, Landon, I need you to go. My stream is going right now. I need you to get in there and start playing Super Auto Pets. And then Layla was like, can I play too? And I was like, go for it. So they were in here doing the Super Auto Pet dance while Kim and I were trying to figure out what the fuck was going on with our ceiling.
Yeah, what happened?
So the fart fan, also known as the yeah. exhaust fan.
Yeah.
There was water coming down from that. And my brain immediately went to my parents' house where an ice dam would build up in this certain corner
yeah.
of the roof. And I was like, all right, well, I know what to do. Get a ladder, get a rake. And I'm like pulling, trying to pull as much as I can off. But no ice is coming off. So I'm like, well, what's going on here? So we get a flashlight and look up. There's no ice. So I'm like, whoa.
Nice.
That doesn't make any sense. So I had to go into the attic. And it's so funny because I went, okay, Kim, I've got it open, but I have irrational fear, so I need you over here.
And she's like, okay.
attics.
Yeah.
Oh, they're terrifying. I think they're scary as fuck.
I'm currently broadcasting from one.
Yeah, but yours doesn't count. I'm talking like there's no
unfinished only.
Yes,
cobwebs.
Exactly.
Okay.
So unfinished, like you open it and there's that breeze that, and I'm just like, ugh.
Like where for sure Jumanji is.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
And it's so cavernous.
Yeah.
That.
There's bats.
Exactly. I was like, yeah. There's got to be fucking bats. The roof to the ceiling, there was such a massive gap that I was like, well, we would see it. We would see where the water's yeah. coming from. We couldn't see anything. So it was underneath the insulation somewhere. I'm like, I'm not doing that.
Right.
Because fiberglass blows.
Yeah.
So we...
Done that before, by the way.
And it's funny, like, I went... I got down from the ladder, and Kim... I was about to walk and go get something, and Kim goes, don't leave. I same fears.
That's so funny.
And then when we needed to close the thing, Kim was like, I am not reaching my hands up in there.
That's funny.
So yeah. I had to do it.
Dude, fiberglass.
And then, so we call an emergency hotline, right?
Yeah.
Which you think means for, you know.
Emergencies.
And they're like, okay, we'll send somebody out in the morning there.
Yeah.
And then this morning they were like, hey, we're not going to be able to get there until this afternoon. And I'm like, God, fuck. So I can't go to work until they show up. I'm like, right. All right, it's fine. And then I get a call at 4 p.m. saying, hey, we're not going to be able to make it. It's like, dude, we have water damage. That's the number one thing.
You should also tell them they need to reimburse you for the hours that you missed at work because they said that.
I don't want to embarrass myself by being like, yeah, give me $80.
It's $80, Chris.
Yeah.
That's a lot of money. Oh, my God.
You know,
I forgot what it's like. this rich kid over here.
Oh, sheesh.
Yeah. But, yeah, so that was just hectic as fuck. But it was funny. So, Mara, what was it like streaming with the kids?
It wasn't for very long. It was just like I got on for a little bit and then Landon immediately was talking shit. It's like, oh, looks like you're gonna die. I'm like, you don't know my strategies. I've been playing this for 200 hours.
You've been running you've been running a snail, the snail meta these days.
What's that?
Oh, you just collect snails in your shop and then.
I do that, yeah.
Especially when you're like running like a Bacta, little Bacta strats. Then you collect snails and you rank them up and then you start running a snail.
Ah! I should do that at some point.
So one more thing. So however long that was taking, right? Kim and I running around with our heads cut off. I look in my office and Layla has this in her hand. And I'm like, And she makes eye contact with me and turns around and goes to put it back, knocks shit over. And I'm like, you guys can stream, but you are not allowed to touch the penis monsters. You're like, okay. Other than that, I mean, oh shit, I haven't been able to talk about the lice and the coronavirus and any of that shit, have I?
I guess not. No.
Fuck. Yeah, it's been a weird couple weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So we find out that Layla has lice and we're like, you know, fuck it. Or no. We found out that Landon had corona first.
No. Layla had lice before.
Yeah. That sounds right.
Does it? Okay. Yeah.
Layla had lice.
So we did the lice dance. Yeah. And then we're like, okay, everybody's in the clear. And then right after we got done recording 2 weeks ago, we got that notification saying that Brandon had the vid. And we were like, God, fuck, man. Can't catch a break. And then we, you know, are going through the motions and what does that say?
Oh, it's just Mara stopped playing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I beat the game.
I couldn't tell if it was an issue or not. But
you should play some Super Auto while we're streaming.
But
and then we can manufacture 10 wins together.
Ah, okay.
And then so it must have been last week. So over this current like the weekend.
Yeah.
Layla and Kim found out that they had lice again. And I was like, you got to be fucking kidding me. Did you guys do the second thing like I told you to? They're like, no, we thought we combed it all out. I was like, ugh. So Kim goes to a specialist. Because then now we find out that Landon fucking has it in his hair. And Kim comes through my hair and I'm like, I am so positive that I don't have it.
Yeah.
And then, so she goes to the specialist. It's a whole ordeal. Spends monies. The next morning, there's a lice bug on Layla's bed. And we're like, So she has to go back. And Kim is like, you need to come too. And I'm like, I don't have it. I know I don't. She's like, what? If you have eggs in your hair, then maybe we're getting it from you. No. So I'm like, I don't want to do this. And I'm working.
Right.
Like, you want me to drive from the shop to St. Cloud,
right,
just to have this lady say you're good and then me go back to St. Cloud. And so we're making deals and things, and she is like, if you have lice and you don't go to this thing, then I get your office. And I'm like, well, fine. If I don't have lice, then you have to pretend to be dead while we have sex next time.
Oh my God. All right.
And she's like, fine. She's so confident. Or no. I had some other deal that I wanted to do. And then,
oh, that was just a side deal?
That was the one that I said when I said, okay, if I go and make this trip and the lady says that I don't have lice, then that was the necrophilia. I go begrudgingly. Guess what? Papa has no lice.
Right.
I look over at Kim and she goes, isn't it nice to know? I'm like, uh-huh.
And you're like, someone gonna die tonight. Die from this dick.
It was hilarious. Because she sent me a text that was like very, you know, head down, tail between the legs.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
And I think the text said, all right, I guess I'll be dead tonight.
Oh, wow.
We never did it, though. But it was just so fucking chaotic. Shit just kept happening. And then, so all the lice stuff is finally over.
Mm-hmm.
Next day is when the fucking leaky thing happens.
It's been a fucking week here at the Dukes, eh?
2 weeks.
Yeah, I suppose. 3 weeks, really.
Yeah.
No, month.
God damn it.
3 weeks ago we found out Layla had lice.
God, fuck. Yeah, so it's been...
flied lice.
Miserable. But the plus side, though... Mara, have you been watching Book of Boba Tits?
I haven't finished it.
No.
I have not finished it either.
Okay.
But...
Yes.
Oh.
Dude. How rad was that?
Unreal.
Like, they nailed it.
It was crazy.
Dude, I saw this article. Nothing pisses me off more than people who are jaded for no reason, you know? Like, when you have, like, a legitimate reason to be jaded, like, I get behind that, right? Like, because I'm like, yeah.
I thought it was very funny. I saw a meme where, you know, Luke is saying, choose between the two things.
Yeah.
And then it shows Anakin and Obi-Wan. And he goes, only the Sith deal in absolutes.
That's funny. But, so I saw some article, literally the title of the article was, Disney and Star Wars have a Luke Skywalker problem.
What?
And I was like, I'm going to hate read this in its entirety. And it was so like, spectacularly wrong about all of its takes, and it was all just like the person basically was like, the entire franchise rides so much on Luke Skywalker that they now have to reintroduce Luke Skywalker into the timeline and all of blah 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 blah. And I'm like,
clearly this person is from Kansas City,
but also like when
he was on the show again, right?
Yeah, and they did like a pretty amazing job with the CGI this time around.
Okay, that's what I heard.
Did you hear the story as to how that happened?
No.
They got the guy that did the deepfake on the YouTube.
You are correct. Shit. Yeah.
That's awesome.
So, they did that. They saw his thing and they were like, well, fine, come fucking work for us.
Yeah.
You know what else that happened in? Hotel Transylvania 4. Adam Sandler was like, the fourth one? Come on. I don't want to do that. So they YouTubed Adam Sandler impersonators. And hired an Adam Sandler impersonator.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
To sound like Adam Sandler, but they didn't credit Adam Sandler, I hope.
I don't think so.
Okay. Anyway, so this whole article, basically like the gist of it was, like I said, it was that Disney has a Luke Skywalker problem and they keep having to like lean on Luke to like keep themselves relevant. But like, that's so adamantly wrong. Like Mando and, well, when he was Baby Yoda, like
I was gonna say,
they were the biggest thing in entertainment.
If they really wanted to be shitty, then they could have said Disney has a Mando problem.
Yeah,
because that's when the views went up.
Right,
is people were like,
Boba Fett was when people were like, oh shit, it's back to Mandalorian. But
there was another meme that said, "This just in: next week's episode is said to feature Boba Fett on the Book of Boba Fett."
Yeah, that's funny. But like, I kind of like that they did it this way, where like they moved the Mandalorian timeline forward.
Yeah.
Without wasting episodes in the Mandalorian. So the like filler episodes of Boba Fett featured the Mandalorian, but he was still a part of the Boba Fett timeline. In that he was still moving the Boba Fett timeline forward, in that he had he was in Mos Eisley and got that ship from, you know, the lady who fucks, why am I blanking? There's so many fucking names of all the creatures in Star Wars, but, they drive
like
the giant
Blux
ship, little fuckers, giant ship. Giant, like, cruiser thing.
Oh, my God.
What are their names? Why am I blanking right now? This is, like, my universe. I need to not blank on this stuff. Not Tauntaun, because that's what Han rides and then cuts open and says,
yeah.
I thought they smelled bad.
God damn it. What are those called? Because they were...
Jawas. So she, the lady that fucks Jawas.
Yes.
Who, like, admits to fucking Jawas, which is
so
very
good.
Funny. But then he, like, at the end, Fennec Shand is like, we need your help. And he's like, I will do it for free. I am happy to help. And then he's like, I just got one more thing I got to take care of. So, like, they're moving the timeline forward. Mm-hmm. Now there's no filler for Mando.
Yeah.
Which, like, yay. But I don't know. It just pissed me off. Anyway, so last Friday, so during the day when I'm working at home, you know, like, I'll just have crap playing in the background. Like, my go-to right now is, like vomit level for you of, like, boring and waste of time. But it's, I've been watching all these United States Golf Association, like, documentaries that are essentially recaps of, like, U.S. Opens. And I've been watching, like, Masters tournament recap, like, documentary videos, and then, like, the Open Championship. So it's the British Open, but if you call it that, people who with stained teeth and whatever freak out of you. So you got to call it the Open Championship. But anyway, so I've been watching all those. But then on Friday, I was like, you know, I'm going to turn a movie on. Like, why not? You know, I'm working. It's Friday. Like, people aren't going to pick up the phone, so I'm just going to be sending emails. Like, I can afford to be watching something that I pay a little bit more attention to. So I turned on Nobody.
Oh.
Yeah.
How was it?
It is spectacular.
Oh, fuck. I got to watch it now.
It is. So it's written by the same guy who wrote John Wick.
Of course.
But my brother told me today, and actually I got to talk to him on the phone for a while today. That was pretty cool. But my brother told me today that Bob came up with the idea for the movie because his house got burgled and he didn't fight back and he felt so guilty. And he was like, what if I had actually just gone complete fucking Rambo on their ass? I'm going to write a movie about that. So he does. So guest stars of the movie, probably the best guest lineup maybe of this century.
Hmm.
Bob Odenkirk's dad is Christopher Lloyd. So
how is he still alive?
I don't know. My brother and I both were like, thought he was dead.
Oh, so many times.
He looks super dead, but he was great in the movie. So good. And then his adopted brother in the movie is RZA from Wu-Tang Clan.
I love, like, comedians having those connections.
Yeah.
Like, it's so funny to me.
And you know that comes from, like, him and David Cross being, like, having Mr. Show and stuff and, yeah, you know, whatever. But so, yeah, RZA and Christopher Lloyd are the two, like, guest stars. And then basically what happens is everything you see in the trailer, like, his house gets broken into. He doesn't fight back, right? But the kickoff point is, like, the next day, his daughter's like, what happened to my kitty cat bracelet?
Oh, yeah.
And he's like, I gotta go. And so he goes to the nursing home where his dad lives, and he, like, walks past his dad, and he's like, hey, Pop. And he's like, what are you doing back here? And he's like, gotta take care of something. And he opens up this closet, and he puts on this fucking swag leather jacket, and then opens up, like, a cigar box, and it's got his dad's old service revolver. And he takes his dad's revolver, loads it, and then takes his dad's old FBI credentials, and he starts going on this, like,
I do want to watch it.
Yeah, I'm not gonna, like, what?
Okay.
So this is all within the first, like, 20 minutes of the movie, by the way. This is, like, so he finally finds the person who, like, you know, broke into his house. And he does it by going to tattoo shops because he's like, did you put this tattoo on somebody? And they're like, no. And he's like, all right. So then he finally gets to the shop and he gets to the counter and he's like, I need to know who this is. Because there's, like, a picture of the tattoo on the counter. He's like, I need to know who that is. And the guy's like, I think you're in the wrong place to be asking us to give information away. And he's like, he flips open the FBI thing or whatever. And this guy sitting over to the side is like, yeah, I don't, that's not yours. And also it's expired. So you can fuck right off. And the guy behind the counter, the owner, is like, this is the wrong place to be using fake credentials to get us to say something. And then Bob like reaches in his pocket. And when he pulls his hand, this is never explained in the movie. So like, I'm not actually giving anything away, but he's just got a tattoo of two different playing cards on his wrist. Like little, like, it's like single line tattoo. Like it's not shaded. It's not, you know, it's just two playing cards. Right. And the guy who's like, who noticed that his credentials were fake is like, oh, and he like gets up out of his chair and he's like, thank you for your service. And then he like runs out of the room and closes this big iron door and locks it like six times and then closes the latch. And everyone in the room is like, yeah, yeah, we'll help you. We'll help you out. So then, yeah, then it kicks off. But he like, he goes after those people, doesn't get what he wants, and then accidentally fucks with the wrong people. And then it's just like, like there's so many parts that are just amazing.
I want so bad for it to come out that like the creators are like, yes, this is in the same universe as John Wick.
Well, and like they're making a sequel. They're making it into a trilogy.
Oh, okay.
And there's a good like cliffhanger at the end where you're like, ah, I knew it. but he, it's so funny. Like just the little nuances in the movie that like separate it from John Wick and separate it from like all those like shoot 'em up movies, like The Accountant and fucking Man on Fire. They all have that
gunpowder milkshake.
Gunpowder milkshake.
Like, they all have like their own. Each superstar like action shoot 'em up guy has their own sort of like signature in each movie, you know, or each, you know, like in Man on Fire and frickin' John Q. Like Denzel's the same guy.
Yeah,
he's just, you know, just playing a different character. Mark Wahlberg is different, same guy and everything, different character. You know, Bob Odenkirk isn't in shoot 'em ups, so he gets to be Bob Odenkirk. Like he makes a proposition at one point to the guy who's coming after him, and he's like, "I'm gonna go out to my car. Like you can either follow me or we can call it a deal now." And then he goes out to his car and he sits in the front seat. And he like looks in the rearview mirror and then he closes his eyes and crosses his fingers like, God, I hope this guy comes after me. And then he sees the guy come out and he has a tape deck in the car, which like, it's 2020. Bob, what are you doing? He slams it in and it's fucking Heartbreaker by Pat Benatar starts playing.
Oh!
And he's just like, it's like full blown car chase. You're like, gah, it's so good, dude. It's great. It's also so unrealistic. It is wonderful. The shit he pulls off in that movie, you're like, this is, it's incredible. It's so good.
Like so, Jackie Chan level or what's up?
No, like completely unfathomable level. Hey, nice win.
Yeah,
oh, good team.
You guys are good luck.
Good team.
Oh, damn.
Always put all, see that? Okay. See that move? Put the stake on the penguin.
I don't even know what the stake is.
Stake adds 25 damage one time.
Jesus Christ.
So that's
you know what's funny? I put the stake on it, and then every match afterwards, that fucker got sniped.
Oh.
I didn't even get to use it.
But Chili Pepper.
But yeah, it's a good strategy.
Chili Pepper level 2 deer is great. Level 3 ant dumps backward. Level 3 badger with a... with the old honey badger, so good.
Yep.
Plus with the damage that it does, like after death, that thing probably does, let's see, is it 3 times or is it?
Yeah, at level 3, it's absurd. It's just, it kills.
It's, I think it's like 5 times almost. It's like, it does like 200 damage or some insane number. But
That was actually my first level 3 badger.
Oh, hell yeah. Add it to the,
I never
add it to the fold.
Pets.
Your first level 3 badger and you got a win with it. So you got the ribbon and the badge.
Yep.
So watch Nobody. Great. Highly recommend. Caitlin and I are still watching all the Star Wars movies. It's going fine. We're now at like the disappointing ones, you know?
Oh yeah.
But like, hopefully Rogue One will impress her, 'cause she hasn't seen that. And I fucking love that movie.
Same.
It's one of my favorites. But I've been watching a lot of like historical documentaries lately,
mm-hmm.
which not normally my cup of tea, I guess. Like I'm more into like the, like if I'm going to watch a documentary like that, it would be like a true crime about a serial killer documentary, you know, where you're like, I want to learn what did John Wayne Gacy do with his pee-pee? You know, like those kinds of things.
Yeah.
I'm watching Hitler's Circle of Evil right now. Holy piss rocket. Dude, it is. It's like the shit that I've learned. You're like, we had so many chances. We had so many chances. Like, did you? Okay, have you guys ever heard this? Like, very few people apparently know about this. But again, you have an opportunity every time to make a genitalia joke with your name in Super
Oh, of course.
The flopping balls. Well done.
Yeah.
I would have named them the extra balls personally, but.
I'm still on the screen.
Oh, bingo. Extra balls.
I like crunchy mouths. It's like, what are your teeth falling apart?
So, okay. Hitler was supposed to give this address to like the citizens of Germany,
mm-hmm.
but it was like a Third Reich rally kind of thing.
Okay.
Post his election and like all that stuff. There was like a time and everything, and he ended up going on stage like 30 minutes early and got off stage 13 minutes before he was supposed to get off stage. And then, he got off stage 30 minutes before he was supposed to get off stage.
Ah.
13 minutes after he got off stage, a bomb went off behind the podium that he was speaking at. And this is all pre-Holocaust. So somebody planted a bomb, and because he got on stage a half hour early, it missed him.
I mean,
nine people died at the explosion of this bomb. He would have died. We wouldn't have had Hitler.
We had, I mean, the guy would go and hold court, you know, for 4 hours at a time.
Putsch.
We could have iced his ass.
I know. It's just like crazy, like the happenstance things that you learn about where you're like, oh my God.
Yeah.
Like his like top officer, the vice chancellor actually at a time was like super into like voodoo and magic with a K and like mind control and all kinds of shit. And his top assistant or his top aide walked in on him one day trying to perform mind control on a chair or trying to perform telekinesis on a chair. And that literally was like the death sentence for that guy. Cause like his top aide then went over his head and was like, hey, Adolf, Robert's being fucking weird.
Well, it's funny though, because I mean, they did go looking for artifacts. So if it had a religious, like, if it had religious lore tied to it,
mm-hmm.
then they were like, yeah. So it's funny that some guy trying to move his chair with his mind is, whoa, 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 whoa.
Well,
that's overdoing it. Go find me the spear that entered Jesus.
Right. Right. Yeah, dude, it's pretty crazy. And like you learn about how cutthroat it was like in that circle, like people just killing each other off, like just to get closer to Hitler. And then the whole time Adolf's like, I'm a good painter. Kill all the Jews, you know? And he didn't even start out as like a super anti-Semite.
No.
He was just like anti-Russia and
anti-fascism.
Yeah.
Huh?
He was a fascist.
Just a tool.
Yeah, yeah.
Just a tool for right. political.
Right. Yeah, it's crazy though.
Yeah, that was bonkers.
So anyway, if you're interested in that, it's on Netflix. It's very, very heavy. Not like an easy watch, you know, the whole time you're like. Also, I should mention last thing, and I said I wasn't going to bring it up on the PCAST, but I figure I should probably tell Mara because it's fun. I got finally got ADHD meds.
Pew, pew, pew.
So taking Adderall.
How many are you snorting a day?
I have the 10 milligram ones. So they come in the gel caps with the beads instead of like like pill form.
Gel caps and beads.
So there's like beads inside the gel cap.
So, oh, because it's supposed to be like a time release thing?
Yeah, but they make it, they designed it specifically so that people couldn't snort it.
Because
like 10 milligrams was like, that was the go-to. Those were the ones you would just chop one up and rail it, and then you'd be fucking humming for.
You know what's funny? I just saw this today. Sean Kingston just did a podcast with somebody, and he talks about how like one of his downfalls was drinking lean with Justin Bieber.
Oops.
Can you imagine Lil Beeb is like, hey, you want some of this purple drink?
Yeah. Hey, I got a hold of some codeine and promethazine. Do you want to drink it together?
Y'all get fucked.
Yeah. Dude, that was the weirdest time in high school was when kids started getting into lean.
And like, they could find it?
Well, yeah.
I thought promethazine was like outlawed in a bunch of states.
Well, they got a hold of a bunch of codeine. So it was promethazine was illegal, but codeine was what they used instead. Because promethazine was what they used prior. Like back in the day when like 3-6 Mafia was talking about lean, they were using promethazine. But now it's codeine. So kids in high school started drinking codeine. Like when everyone went off to college, there was like the group of kids that were all like snorting Percocet and stuff in high school that did not go to college, you know? And then you would like see pictures on Facebook of them like throwing up gang signs and like wearing Atlanta Braves hats and like and like the double stack foam cup with the fucking Jolly Ranchers in it. And
oh like, my God.
You're like, guys, what are we doing?
So dumb.
And now they like take pictures of themselves with like a shit ton of filters on it. And they're like sitting at the base of a tree and they look like a ghost. And the caption says like, come at me. My father wanted nothing but love with the kittens of the future. And you're like, your brain is broken.
That's, oh, now I remember how I went on this weird like track of musical shenanigans. So I told you, so I was telling Alex before we started recording that I watched this Father's Reaction to When I'm Gone by Eminem, because it's real sad if you're father. But then I saw in the corner.
It's real sad if you're a human being with empathy.
I saw in the corner Tribals react to some music video. I was like, what? Oh, the Cranberries. It's like, what the fuck is this? So I click on it. And it's Indian people. Pretty sure there was a Sikh guy. And they're, so it's all in Indian. And they're just watching music videos. And like them, the questions that they have for music videos, because we've seen how many of those, like 5-year-olds react or grandparents react. Blah, blah. The questions that they have were so interesting. Like the Cranberries music video. There's these kids that are look like, what are those called? What's Cupid? He's a
cherub.
Yeah. Cherub. So these little cherub kids are like, they have bows and arrows, and the Indian, this one Indian guy's like, why do the children have weapons? And the guy like explains it. He articulates so well, like the whole concept of all of these music videos. But so they watch Disturbed's version of The Sound of Silence. And they're like, why does he have the two things in his? And the guy, they must ask about like body modification so much that the guy who's, you know, the producer is like I've told you before. It's just a style. And then the guy finishes a sentence. It's stylistic choice. Like, apparently Indian people just fucking hate when we shove shit in our faces.
Which is kind of, to some degree, it's a little ironic, actually.
Yeah, it's very funny. But I wrote down.
All right, Mara, I'm controlling the shop this game.
I see you.
The Sikh guy said something that was very interesting to The Sound of Silence, right? So the lyric where he says 10,000 people more.
Yeah.
But the concept being that they...
10,000 people, maybe more.
But he still couldn't hear anything. They're not making a sound.
Right.
And they can't hear him either. So it's like he's explaining that to the Sikh guy. And he goes, ah, only knowledge or creativity can break ignorance. And I was like, one more time?
you want to run that back for me there, Abed?
Holy piss, dude. Like, that's awesome. You just, it was like mystical.
Well, that's such a cool feeling too when you're like, it's like, wisdom is like cross-cultural, you know? Like,
yeah.
You're like, oh.
Everyone's
smart.
What a cool way of stating that too. Yeah. Like,
yeah. Except for Polish people. We're all pretty dumb.
Yeah, man. Now let's go drink mustard.
Hey, you guys want to have potatoes with cheese in them? Yeah. You want to make it really hard to make them? And
what does a Polish person sound like?
I mean, it's Eastern Bloc, so like...
It's damn near Russian, right?
Yeah. Never buy ants. I'm on the anti-ant meta.
I'm anti...
I like to kill them with pills.
I know, but if you... Well, buy your mosquito, freeze your... Okay.
Freeze?
Yeah. You're fine. Do what you want.
I want multiples of the bugs I got, okay?
I know.
Dude, hot fingers.
See, with this one, I would do the fussy fingers because you get the alliteration and it's yummy.
Yeah, I agree.
Umami.
What did you want me to freeze, just for reference?
The cricket.
Oh. Boo.
Well, cricket's a perfect ant killer.
Justin had been talking about how there was like the number one piercing shop in Minnesota shut down. And they were having an auction for all of the stuff that was in the shop. And he's like, I'm going to run train on this shop. And we're going to basically be a hybrid anamorph of St. Sabrina's and modified.
Teenage Witch?
Yeah.
St. Sabrina's Teenage Witch. I'm in on that.
So I'm going to bleep this number out. Well, let me tell this story first. So we're looking at all of the shit that you can get from this shop, and it's just astronomical. It's wild. He's dreading like not getting certain things, and then we find out that you have to be able to be there the very next day to get all the shit and get out of there. So if you win an auction for something, you have to be there the next day at a certain time. And he's stressing out about that because it's on a Monday and that's like, you know, beginning of the week for us. And
right.
Dasa, dasa, dasa. So he figures that out, gets a moving company. We find out the morning of that he spent dollars on this auction. He won almost all of the things that he bid on. So he had to take a loan out just to get all the shit. But the shop is going to look like completely different now.
It's so worth it.
Crazy.
And he can probably write off some of that loan because it's business expenses.
Yeah. All of it is business stuff. It was really funny, like the state of things. It was basically like a bunch of people that owned a shop, a bunch of artists together that went in on the shop. It was so dope. Like, it was very cool looking. It had like a cottage feel on the outside and then pretty cool on the inside. Except in the lobby, it had those like plastic connecting things that make a floor. It looks like Lego tops.
Yeah.
And I was like, why?
Yeah.
If you have a floor like that, you make it seem like somebody throws up daily in your shop.
Yeah, and like, also like it looks elementary as fuck.
Yeah.
Like, why would you?
So, like cinnamon smelling wood chips everywhere. Yeah.
Is that cinnamon or cedar?
How are there always goldfish underneath this keyboard? But so all of the stuff that we got.
Their air freshener is just the Crayolas that have scent and they just take all the caps off.
Exactly. They had like these cool, like, you know, like potion bottle aesthetic kind of shit, right? And the movers are all bringing the shit in. And we're like, oh, we didn't know that he was getting some of the stuff that he got. And we were like, oh, he got those weird decorations. And one of the movers goes, yeah, there's still candy in them. And we're like, what? There was candy in all of the things. So they didn't even bother emptying out this fucking who knows Jesus. How old candy. Because it's not wrapped candy.
Right.
It's candy that they poured like, into these
somebody
things.
Go to prison and they just needed to get everything out of there? Or?
I don't know. This is a weird, weird situation.
It's funny, though.
And then they put... they just got rid of all of these gallons of distilled water. They put them in the garbage bins that we got. And so we'd go to pick up a garbage thing and be like, holy fuck. Look inside and there's just gallons of water. What the fuck?
That's really funny.
And then some of them burst.
Oh my God, that's such a pain.
Yeah, it was chaotic as fuck.
Well, fun.
Yeah, fun, 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 fun. It's going to look super dope.
That's sweet. Also, Mara, next round. Pour for blood.
So
this
for
is
the
why you got to come to the stream.
Yeah,
I know. This is fun. I'm enjoying.
Yeah.
So I mean, I'd prefer you here, but this is.
So Alex, what we can do is you come over some night. We put you in Landon's room.
Yes.
And then we can all stream and do a thing.
Ooh, that's an idea. I like that. Cupcake your mosquito.
So for the listeners, Alex is guiding Mara. Well, they're teaming up.
And then buy that second crab.
On Super Auto Pets, which you can watch Mara stream.
Ooh, thanks for that tech. I didn't know that's how that worked.
Yeah. And then...
we're going to have a streamer on the 23rd come on the show.
Who is?
His name's Sam Fassler.
Oh, okay.
He's a wonder... think of like Clifton, but as a musician. Well, Clifton is a musician. Basically, Clifton without the comedy.
Okay.
Well, the stand-up.
Okay.
Because he is funny.
Okay.
But he has over 1,000 followers on his stream.
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And
68. Yeah.
Ooh. I have 7.
Bussin'.
What's up? I asked him what his favorite games to stream with others are. And he said Overwatch.
Oof.
CSGO.
CSGO. Neither of which you would like.
They're all FPS
next.
Games.
Yep.
They're all what?
First person shooters.
I love first person shooter.
Yeah, Overwatch is a nightmare if you don't know how to
nightmare,
play.
Yep.
And people are so fucking mean on Overwatch. For being the most cartoonish like FPS game, people are brutal. Like if you
we
don't
played anything, it would be Halo, and it would be like
that was his other
deathmatch mode.
Yeah, I mean,
Halo Infinite was the other one that he said.
Yeah. We play the piss out of some Halo.
Is that the one that you can play on Steam?
Yeah.
Yeah, I say we fucking do that and just.
I would need an Elgato.
You do?
Because I would play it on Xbox.
Oh,
well, you could play it on your computer.
No, I don't think my computer can.
Oh,
well, my computer. Oh, that's the other fucking thing that happened. So
I couldn't even run Phasmophobia.
Yeah, I suppose.
What? Phasmophobia.
Easy.
Oh, sorry. Yeah.
Spelled with a PH. It's okay.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I saw the text. I just didn't reply. I was like, I am way too far out of this to be able to participate.
But so I needed to get Streamlabs and all the shit set up. And I was like, you know what? I have a child with ADD that can fucking do this for me. So I call Landon up and I'm like, hey, man, help me do the things. And he's like, okay. He's up here for 2 minutes. And... slightly moves the microphone, knocks over a soda, it flips upside down, lands directly on my tower.
Did you just hang him out back by his nutsack or?
So Landon has PTSD with like, he recognizes really quickly.
Yeah.
Everything sinks in when it's something.
Yeah.
Like he feels the gravity of it real quick.
Yeah.
And so I saw that he had that on his face because my initial reaction was, what the fuck?
Yeah.
But as I'm, I see his face and I'm like, oh no. I'm like, wow, okay. You go get a towel And I'm going to say cunt like a lot while you're gone. And oh man, it was so stressful.
Yeah.
So stressful. Because the top of the thing looks like vents.
Yeah.
So I was like, okay, so just a straight
right
shot.
Right into everything.
Right into everything.
Did you, ugh, just put it in rice or?
No.
I'm so glad that hit you as hard as it did. I thought it was so funny. When
very
I
funny.
Thank you.
But no, it was a whole, it took over an hour to like,
I imagine,
get everything.
Well,
like,
now you're going to have ants.
Oh man. Yeah.
Nightmare.
And we know what ants do to your CPU. So.
You know, ants suck your dick. Whoops. Next page.
But yeah, that was fucking gnarly. And then finally, I think it was Sunday when I started
A-T-T.
Doing this shit.
A-T-T, dump the hedgehog.
What?
Always take turtle. AT&T meta. Now, move your crab behind your giraffe. Save your crab because it's turn 6, and on turn 7, you get level 5 animals.
See, I never memorized the turn thing.
So it's always on odd-numbered turns.
Okay.
So then...
Speaking of cupcakes, my birthday was last week. Huzzah, huzzah. And then tomorrow is two. So by the time you guys watch this, 2 years of sobriety.
Yay!
As of February 10th.
Congratulations, dude.
Grazie. In other
than ever.
Sobriety news, Bobby Lee relapsed and is going back into rehab.
Is that a weed thing or was he?
He went full bore.
Meth?
Weed, pills, alcohol.
No, Bobby Lee.
I know. 2,000 milligrams of edibles a day. Yeah.
Bobby Lee raps.
Jesus.
It's right? So depressing because, like, when you see it happen that way, he went 17 years sober. And then he had the one relapse after his dad passed away. And it's like, okay, that I can see that because mm-hmm. I've had those thoughts where it's like, if I don't know how I would handle.
Well, how do you cope with loss?
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
I don't know how I would handle a loss like that, especially my dad. Like,
well, he and his dad were very different.
Exactly.
We're a very different situation, so I can't even fathom.
That's what I'm saying,
right,
is like,
right.
if in that, like, where his dad was an absolute cock.
Like a literal abuser.
Yeah. although... it is really funny.
The stories are so good.
They are hilarious. Because
Mara Apple, the mosquito.
To have an abusive dad that, like, is...
Say Apple?
Yep.
He's basically an on-call abusive father.
Right.
Where at any hour of the day, no matter what he's wearing, he will get up, like, hearing about him having... rolled up toilet paper in between his butt cheeks.
How he would run past the room because he thought it was haunted.
Could you imagine your dad coming into your room in his underwear, ready to fucking throw down?
And he's got toilet paper in his butt crack.
Like, jarring enough that your dad is about to fight you, but he's not wearing anything.
Right. And also, you have a friend over, and then he beats you over the back with a keyboard.
There was some warriors in the past that would fight naked because it was terrifying.
Yeah, yeah,
they
that's
would cover
a thing.
Themselves in lime and wear like animal statues on their head.
Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah, and then they would have crazy orgies the night before.
That's
no
right.
Toilet paper in the butt though.
The pagans.
Right. Don't freeze the crab and the turn. Run that shit.
Sending it.
But so all of that to say, right? To then
this is a win.
The pattern that happens after, like, because Bobby has a bunch of money now.
Yeah.
And because of the things that he has, and like, it's so fucked up to think about, but like, Kalila's not going to leave him because they have two podcasts. They have all of these, they're like an empire now.
Right.
So in the back of his mind, he's got that, like, what are you going to do?
Right.
I'm going to fucking relapse right now.
Right.
He doesn't grasp why it's happening.
Right.
So it's maddening on my end to be like, back to that thing that we were talking about where we're like, if I just had the opportunity to talk to them, I know that I could.
Right.
Like, it's a, I know it's like an idea of grandeur, but no one in the fucking addiction world talks about the whole three-step thing. It's like you keep tying it to like, I was fingered by my second grade music teacher and that's why I shoot heroin.
Right.
Like, sure, maybe, but also you shot heroin and then you activated that thing in your brain that has objective truths to it.
Right.
So let's confront that shit.
Right.
And then the mental health.
Right.
Because that usually solves these other problems.
Right.
So or at frustrating. Least
teaches you how to cope with them.
Yeah. Better. It's a huge step.
So we got just poop raped on that one.
Yeah. I like that you said poop, but the rape, you're fine. Yeah. Just
I wasn't. I hate that word. I didn't even mean to say it, but it happened.
Speaking
we're
of
off by a 11 health.
Yeah, that was tough.
Speaking of words you shouldn't say, David Cross has a new special, which I'm very excited for. It's going to stream February 16th, I think.
Netflix?
On his website.
Oh.
So there's going to be a live showing.
Oh, and then he'll...
And then he's going to do...
Cause he's
I don't
with,
know if he's doing YouTube or...
Because he's with Comedy Dynamics, right? Isn't that his...
I don't know. I don't know. I know he had like a contract with HBO and there's a whole thing. But
holy
but British. Now it seems like he's just doing whatever. And I'm very excited about it because he was on Your Mom's House and they were asking him questions and he was like, it's such a bummer that I didn't get to tour with the majority of this material because he misses people walking out of his shows because he's so fucking vile.
Well, he's like, it's so funny because part of it is his voice.
And yeah.
Part of it is the fact that he plays Tobias Funke, that people just assume that he's going to be like silly.
Well, and he's in three Chipmunk movies.
Right.
Like you.
Yeah.
It's asinine.
Dude, one of the funniest jokes I've ever heard is the elephant shitting joke. Have you heard that one?
I can't remember.
So I forget what album.
That's the weird
it's on.
Thing is like I don't remember any of his bits because they're so like long form.
I forget what album it's on, but he is like sitting. It's like super hot out, and there's like a circus happening, and it's like all sweaty and gross, and like they are trying to make this elephant like do tricks, and like the elephant is clearly sick and like not doing well. And they're like hitting the elephant and like making it move. And it finally gets up on the thing and it like does its twirl. And as it's twirling, it just starts shitting. It just shits all over the audience. So like people in the front row got got wet and wild with elephant shit, which was like he like in his mind, he's like, this is the perfect thing. Like to have like it sucks for the elephant, but like what a great piece of revenge! Like this elephant had to do this on purpose.
Oh,
like, shut up, you fucking baby! Released in 2002.
Yeah.
Ah, yes.
Okay, Cupcake, the mosquito.
One
let
of
me
my.
See if I can, let me see if I can predict your line here.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm guessing we sell giraffe, snail, add crab.
No. Cupcake, mosquito.
What?
Buy crab. Sell giraffe. Buy crocodile. Or no. Whoa. Buy snail. Buy snail.
Wait, what? What? Okay, what's so good about snail?
Snail does a +2/+1 buff after you lose. Now sell snail, buy crocodile, put it behind crab, and roll.
Now why wouldn't you snail first?
What do you mean? Oh, should have snailed before because then you get the extra buff.
Right.
Okay. Good call. Freeze the pill. That's it. Run it.
It's going.
My favorite.
I haven't played much crocodile yet.
Crocodile's so fun. Does 8 damage to the back enemy.
I my favorite David Cross, what's the word I'm looking for? Like factoid. If we've discovered factoid is it could be true, it might not be true.
Oh, I don't
know.
It's
one of those weird things.
Okay.
So
usually it's not true.
Oh, usually it's not true. Okay. Okay. But this one is true. So my favorite like random tidbit about David Cross is he wore a BDSM mask on an airplane for the whole plane ride.
Oh yeah.
And
I've heard this.
He did an interview
like the zipper and everything.
Oh yeah. And so he does this, right? And he's like, hilarious thing for me.
Right.
He does an interview and somebody's like, so I heard you recently wore a BDSM mask on an airplane. And he's like, how the fuck do you know that? I didn't tell anybody.
Right.
So somebody figured it out. And like interview after interview, he was like, I still don't fucking understand how people know that. But yeah, I did it. I loved it. It was hot.
Yeah.
But like, it's so funny that he's like, I can't even do a joke for me. Everybody knows. Right.
Now it's a joke for everyone. All right, next.
But that dude is just so, so brave.
Yeah, dude.
Like, especially.
Well, and like the comedy troupe he came up with, too.
Oh. Like, I mean.
Well, him and Bill Hicks. And.
They were so ahead of their time. Like, nobody, I don't think anybody could have predicted that that's what it was going to be.
Well, you know, that's how Tenacious D got started.
Yeah.
Which is also fucking insane.
Because they, Ben Stiller produced, was the executive producer for a show that David Cross and basically the Mr. Show cast and why can't I think of Rick and Morty?
Justin
Dan Harmon.
Dan Harmon.
Oh, yep.
Dan Harmon.
Justin Roiland, but other Rick and Morty guy.
But yeah, they started a show, and then the whole and Jack Black was in it, and it was it would have been incredible.
Yeah,
if they would have released that show now, even if it wasn't Jack Black, would have been incredible. But like nobody knew that this shit was going to happen. That Tim and Eric was going to take off. That yeah. fucking. The Eric Andre show, like all of these.
Dude, Tim and Eric.
Well, and then that leads way for I Think You Should Leave.
Yeah.
Like.
Well, Tim Robinson and what's his name? Sam from Detroiters, who are also, he's also one of the main guys in I Think You Should Leave. He's the big black guy.
I was going to say the black guy, right? Yeah.
So Tim was on, he was like a coach at Second City or something in Detroit, like. One of the Second City outlets, I think he was an improv coach there, but Sam, he said, was like the only guy in the improv class that was like, he's like, yeah, so he's like the only guy that was like, I could actually riff with. And then I realized like, oh, he's like a beginner. Like this kid's like legit. And then that's when they started writing together. And then Tim got on SNL as a writer.
Mm-hmm.
And then He tells this in an interview with Seth Meyers, but he literally is like, not one of my sketches ever got aired, but it would be because he would come up with like the craziest shit for celebrities to do exclusively. So it'd be like he would make it so that like the celebrity would have to like pretend that they were like eating a bowl of shit or something, like just like totally. And Lauren would be like, what the fuck, dude? But
that's the same thing Hannibal Buress did.
Yeah. But he's also the guy who's in the Bubba 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 basketball sketch, which is arguably the best SNL sketch of the 2010s, in my opinion.
Mm.
It's him and Jason Sudeikis play like the guys who write for NBA on TNT.
Oh, okay.
And they like, I think Alec Baldwin is on that episode. And so it's Alec and Keenan and I forget who the gal is that they have in there. And so the two brothers come in and the Sudeikis plays the keyboard. So he actually, he plays the theme for NBA on TNT. It's like, remember that like
yeah.
from the 90s or whatever it was. And then he's like, and my brother Bill wrote the lyrics for the song. And then it, like, he starts the song, and Tim Robinson just jumps in. He's like, basketball, give me the ball, because I'm gonna dunk it. And they're like, can we try it like without the singing? Then Sudeikis is like, no, the singing has to be a part of it. So it's, like, it's very funny. It's I love that bit. Marin, you can go back to the shop.
Thoughts on
Bulls and the Trailblazers. Oh, that's Jordan versus
she's
Drexler.
Playing. Yeah. Oh, it's Kate McKinnon.
Why did it all go green?
And it's John Hamm? It's not Alec Baldwin. John Tesh
is here. Oh great, send him in.
Okay. Oh no, it's fucking Vince Vaughn.
This guy is amazing. You know, he wrote the theme to Entertainment.
Oh, there it is.
Knock knock. Hello. There he is, Mr. Entertainment tonight. How you guys doing?
So
hello,
it's
everyone.
John, he plays
this
John
my brother
Tesh.
Brother right here, Dave Tesh.
A pleasure, pleasure.
I did not know that you had a brother.
Oh, yeah, you know, he's not just my brother. He's also the genius in the family.
Meanwhile, I'm blushing.
Well, John, my boss told me
he's
a new
so
theme
good.
Song for the NBA on NBC.
Basketball's a little repetitive.
Yeah,
good point.
I feel like we just prefer the song better without the lyrics.
Okay. Okay, but without the lyrics, how will people know it's about basketball, you know?
Well, we'll be playing it over clips of basketball.
Because we thought it might go this way.
You know what? What? You take this one alone, Johnny.
What about you?
Don't you worry about me. This isn't the last you're going to hear of old Dave Tech.
Very good.
Anyway, Mari, you can go back to the shop.
Now, we have the... Oh, my God. Oh, Alex, could you sing the intro for...
I forgot what it is. Oh.
Oh, you came up with an intro?
Yeah, what? I forgot what I said.
What that brain do?
Oh, yeah.
What that brain do? Thank you.
That's beautiful.
Thank you.
Okay, so we've got the Pearly Gates. We've got Purple Drank.
Are we looking at any red herrings?
There are no red herrings. It's actually like... the same thing like three times.
holy Kool-Aid in hand.
Have any events in history happened with Kool-Aid?
That's what I keep trying to go
with.
So
is it okay? Is it Heaven's Gate?
It is.
Is that the correct answer?
No.
Yeah, it's Heaven's Gate.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
Do you know
yeah.
This?
Yeah. Okay. So yeah, Heaven's Gate was a cult.
Oh, that was the name of it.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah.
And they were the originators of the Kool-Aid. Actually, or was that Jim Jones was the originator of the Kool-Aid? I don't know.
I don't know.
They both did the Kool-Aid.
Yeah. Okay. Now that makes sense.
Bunch of mass suicides via Kool-Aid.
Yes. So it was one of those ones where it's hidden in plain sight.
Yeah. Heaven's Gate.
You see this part, though, right?
Yeah, that was the one
part
too.
That confuses me. That's why I'm...
That's the gate.
Very good.
I guess I don't get it.
Oh.
When your walking style is your gait...
Oh, wow. Okay, yeah, what that brain do. I got it right and I didn't even understand it.
That's so funny.
Go team.
Oh, my God.
Chris knows this one because we talked about it.
Pizza, pizza.
Yep.
Very good.
That's so funny. You did it exactly like... Actually, even better than we discussed. That's so funny. So there's this dude named Kyle Beats, and he has this this fucking plugin where you just put two clicks and perfect. Like, so he advertised it as you drop the plugin on your master track, and then you click on one preset, pick your preset. And then you click one thing to adjust it, and then it's just supposed to be amazing.
And it's not.
Never. Never, ever, ever.
Oh, that's
and so I
funny.
Keep tricking myself. I'm like, maybe this time. No.
Never this time.
Never this time.
All right.
And if you are like ever into beat making on YouTube, like you saw his ad for this shit, like.
Oh, yeah.
Video. Irritating.
It's so funny because the Kenny Beats is a good producer.
Yeah.
And he's like, I'm so fucking sick of seeing this Kyle guy. And he even stole my shit. Kyle Beats, Kenny Beats.
Kenny Beats beats Kyle Beats.
Two clicks and it's perfect. Like he was just talking
Kyle's
mad shit.
Good too.
Is he? Wow.
A pornucopia.
You got it.
Wow. Excellent. What?
And I didn't like, I didn't, when I was picking pictures, these were just the first ones.
Hottest Bitches Magazine.
Bang a midget?
Yes.
Volume yeah. 2.
And it's got like Harry Potter letters.
It yeah, does. That's.
Like, why? It says six big scenes.
Maybe there's just a bunch of scenes with guys with herpes and they call them their Hogwarts.
Oh.
So good. Thank you.
It's a deep cut from the 90s.
Yeah. Oh, man. Dude, I hate that guy on the far left so much. Everything he was in drove me crazy.
Bernie Sanders? that was a joke about left.
Yeah, he
oh,
very,
I got it.
It was very good.
Oh, okay.
Okay, okay.
I forgot what this contraption is called.
I mean, it's a crossbow.
Well, it's not a crossbow.
I know. That's what I'm trying
it's
to...
The
I keep wanting to say trebuchet, but it's...
Also not that.
Lethal trebuchet.
Well,
they kill dragons.
Yeah.
Yeah. The turret?
All right. Do you know the person?
Sarah McLachlan.
The actress's name?
No, I know. I'm trying to remember.
Oh, okay.
Never seen it, so I don't know.
Yeah, I don't.
I know Lucy Liu's in it.
It's like 1999.
Can see her on the right. Shit.
It was like a response to Sex in the City, but like trying to make it more G-rated. Bon Jovi showed up at one point.
Okay, so is it like?
I mean, if you can't get the name,
is it like a '90s actress?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't remember.
I think I only remember her from this.
Oh, geez. Well, then I don't. I
she's
can't.
Married to Harrison Ford.
Oh,
still?
Yeah. The Google images made it seem like it.
That's wild.
I don't know. Who is?
All right, I'm going to tell you what the device there is. It's a ballista.
Duh. Ballista McCarthy?
It's Ballista Flockhart.
Oh, Melissa Flockhart.
I don't know who that is.
Ballista.
Huh?
It's Callista.
Her name was Callista Flockhart.
Well, who's Melissa Flockhart?
Not a thing.
You just made that person up.
Shit.
I'm sorry.
Oh. Trisha Fightatus?
That rules. I wish it was that. That is not Trisha, though.
Oh, it's not? Is that Coco?
Oh, it's not a specific person. It's more of an aesthetic.
Okay, so it's a bimbo. Mm-hmm.
Oh, bimbo slice.
Bimbo slice.
Nice. That's so funny.
That's it.
Oh.
Trisha Fietis.
that guy was like, damn, son.
I mean, excellent work, by the way. It's so funny.
The Photoshop
like,
is so good.
Yeah, that's a. I'm
it
like,
literally looks like Kimbo Slice is wearing a mask.
Exactly. Of, yeah,
that's a piece of paper.
It's
of
like
this person.
Bimbo armor.
Yeah,
but he got it from Party City. So, Alex, over the last, I'd say, 6 months, you look like one of those guys who works at the Boys and Girls Club, but only plays basketball if the hoop has the chains on it instead of the string. Just like the sound when I drain it.
You hear that? That's the Brinks truck backing up. This is where I make my money. Okay, so this guy is having more fun than all of us, and he deserves it, and we kind of deserve it too.
God damn. I mean, is he the wacky flailing arm inflatable tube man?
I also just thought this song kicked so much ass. I've also never seen a drummer this talented that moves that much.
I was going to say, so malleable.
God damn it. There we go.
Where? Next. Oh, man, it's not on... It's not on his talk. It must be on his gram.
Pirate radio where the truth can't be silenced. Today's question, is the earth flat or is it shaped like a window? Welcome to Pirate Radio where the
TikTok,
truth can't
why are you like
be...
Dude, you did that so perfectly, though. Or is it shaped like a river? That was weirdly
Welcome
timed.
To Pirate Radio where the truth can't be silenced. Today's question, is the earth flat or is it shaped like a long poo? More after this. Welcome to Pirate
that
Radio.
That guy gets
with
me every time.
Dude, his voice is just yep. incredible.
The baddest on the microphone apparatus.
You know Randall
here.
Park?
When I rock a rhyme off and eyes are dropping a tear. It's so beautiful, it's America's landscapes when this man makes lyrics like the syrups that you pour upon your pancakes. Just to grip minds like a handshake, spit a Lando Lakes and go skinny dip with the fan base over any damn breakbeat. I hastily make pastries tastier than anything that Wolfgang makes. So take notes out of suckers. I make coats, lump a sum like Bubba Gump fishing on lake boats.
What the fuck?
Turn the comedy into drama. I'm bagging on your mama. I'm Jeffrey Dahmer behind you. I'm a rhyme writer. Lock, stock, smoking the ganja. Rebuttals befuddle, leaving a puddle of saliva, sillies. You couldn't handle Randall when I throw my grammar at you. It hit your head and you would think I threw a hammer at you. I point the camera at you like Herb Ritz. Develop it, then use the pictures to pick up bird shits. You're nervous is the impervious wordsmiths hanging out in Rafa's new crib come with the verses.
Dude, Randall Park is a great rapper.
It's so funny because he still sounds sad.
Yeah, and also you're just like, you want him to ask about magic.
Yeah.
Talk to Paul Rudd.
God damn it, where is this video?
Don't worry, I got a plethora. You don't have to scramble. Just keep looking. You got it. I love that song. I've loved that song since I was a small child.
Same. I'm smart, but I'm stupid. I'm gay, but I'm straight. I cook dust in Whole Foods. Baby, what it all comes down to.
I just love I crop dust in Whole Foods.
So good. I'm gay, but I'm straight.
Ooh, look.
What?
See, the guy does like a... what's that fucking movie?
Ghost Rider?
Ghost Rider.
Yeah, he does the Ghost Rider thing, and then... The next scene is a guy who's a burn victim. Like, his head is burned.
Oh!
Yeah, so the guy is, like, trying not to laugh.
I mean, it's... Why with the music always?
I don't know.
Come on, talkers.
That's how you get seen, man. We don't know what we're doing.
That's true.
I got my first real six string. Boy, it after five and done. Played it till my fingers bled.
Caption says, making you hear the lisp. He just keeps adding, at all of the S's, he just goes, so, played it till my fingers bled. Was the summer of 69. I love that video. Funny.
Okay, it's good.
This one killed me, dude.
Let me tell you, for any reason, you got to go outside. Man, be careful. It's slippery. Yeah, I fell a little bit ago.
You see it? Yeah. Oh my god. The greatest, like, dude, just.
You know what, dog? Neither can I. It's okay. Also, I was today years old when I found out that I'm allergic to cashews. Surprise, Sade.
The very end. Sade.
Women are smarter than men. We know that, right? Here's the, I think you know women are smarter than men by how often they return stuff. Right? Women are like, oh, I'll just get my money back. Right? And men are like, oh, this is my new bad shirt. And a mulching shirt. I'll die in this shirt. Women are smarter than men. We know that.
Keith bid on a shelf at that shop.
Yeah.
Solely because at the bottom corner he saw a little Star Wars box.
Yeah.
He was like, I want to know what's in that box. And the shelf came, no Star Wars box.
What?
Right? So he kept showing us.
Scam.
He's like, this is why I got it. And with each person we'd go, what's in it? And he's like, I don't know. But that's why I bid on it.
Sucks. So basically, oh, I love this one. As a suffix for anything that has a hole. So, you know, if there was a hole in the ground, that would be grussy. Or like a dolphin would have a dolphussy. Does that make sense? What are you here for anyway?
I was charged with high treason in the year 1763 and publicly hanged.
Damn, that's crazy. I just watched Tentacle. I didn't even like tell you about that yet. So basically.
What?
This person is fucking hilarious. She does a whole, or they, excuse me, they do a whole.
I was going to say, that's a they for sure.
They do this whole bit about like role play, sexual role play.
Oh.
And they're like, I don't know, Mara, you might be able to find that one. It's so funny.
But I mean, what was they just doing?
They were in hell explaining to someone that died like 300 years ago
what
the suffix "ussy" meant.
So funny.
And in context.
See, I still can't see because I'm blind bitch.
So this is fruit roll-up in butter. The fruit roll-up in the butter is frozen. I had in the freezer overnight. I always do that. This is vinegar and thyme. Super good, super good.
What the fuck?
Dip it, and... So juicy.
So juicy?
I'm so upset right now.
Same.
Oh, man.
That's my TikTok for you.
Oh. God.
Fruit roll-up and butter.
What, did she get that recipe?
Dip it in vinegar?
Did she get that recipe from Doima?
Dude, stop.
Oh, gross.
If you go back to that... That person who did the...
Yeah, I'll get there.
The ussies.
What is the weirdest, like, food combo that you do that you can think of?
Oops.
I don't know.
My,
this video is so fucking funny.
Did you watch it?
We're definitely watching
shit.
The shit out of
it. Have you watched Murderville yet?
No. I've heard it's pretty good.
Dude. Marshawn Johnson?
Marshawn Lynch.
Yeah. Marshawn Lynch. He fucking immediately. So, you know, Will Arnett's doing his thing.
Yeah.
And he goes straight into character. He's like, yo, my name's not Marshawn. Oh, well, what's your name then? Detective Bag-a-Bitch. And Will Arnett's like, I'll have to talk to HR about that. Oh, fuck.
I saw there's a Marshawn cameo in Brooklyn Nine-Nine, and it's this episode where, like, all these criminals escape out of this van. They're in, like, transit to another prison, and he's, like, eating tacos, like, on the street, right? And this van, like, crashes behind him, and, like, there's a big explosion. Like, people run out of the van in orange jumpsuits, and he, like, looks down at his takeout, and he's like, oh, man. They forgot my pico de gallo. It's so fucking funny.
Blaze.
What?
Hey, Blaze.
What?
We've been trying to, Blaze. Trying to what? Reach you about
the Can you, do you catch what he's saying at the end?
Uh-uh.
We've been trying to. What? Reach you about your car's extended warranty.
That's really funny. All right. Well, that's all I got.
Yeah. It's funny because I want to keep... now I'm like, I want to start playing video games.
Yeah.
All that super auto pets. Follow us, Dude Absolutely Pod, on Twitch. twitch.tv/DudeAbsolutelyPod. And Mara, what is yours again?
MaraJade84.
That's right. Temporary sun goddess.
Also, don't forget to like and subscribe if you're watching on YouTube. Don't forget to like us or follow us on Spotify for more updates.
Mm-hmm.
On Apple Podcasts, you can leave a review. You know, if you do read a review, we'll read it live on the show. And
if they do read a review, then we'll read it on the show?
Yeah, if they write a review, we'll
write
read
a review.
It.
There you go.
I'm dumb.
You said read two times.
Anyway, thanks for watching. Same time next week.
Dude!
Absolutely.
Y'all. Mara, I love you.
Love you.
She finally said it!
Yes!
Dude.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
Dude.
Absolutely.
Dude, absolutely.